My biggest problem is that people believe that hackers in cyberspace got like a very strange motivation. You know, it's like, it's hard to imagine be the hacker, right? And they kind of believe that a hacker is a bad guy who tries to hack into a system just for maybe for fun or for profit. But I think we have left that behind really, really long ago. Today, state-sponsored attacks are really dangerous. Only China has 30 to 40,000 hackers.
As part of the government payroll.
Of course, employed by the government. And all the other countries are trying to catch up. You know, it's not like the US is trying to get as many people as they can on board. Of course, there's a little bit of problem here because, you know, recruiting people for the government is not easy, especially in an area of cybersecurity where you can get a lot of money from private companies. So, like, why would I join the government? I think it's a little bit easier in China. I'm not familiar with their, I'm not familiar with their, you know, methods, but I can imagine. So, but on the other hand, I mean, there are state-sponsored attacks, and also the cyber criminals, actually like real criminals, move to the cyberspace because it gives them the kind of anonymity that they require, and they can also make a lot of money. Just take ransomware. When you know they can hold your computer for ransom, and if you're not paying that $10, $100, whatever you name it, then you know all data is going to be deleted or worse, sent to the dark web. You know, they're selling your data, or maybe you're paying and they're selling your data. You never know. And so through these campaigns, the people behind the campaign can get somewhere between $10 million to $30 million if they're doing it right. So it's big business. And when there's business, you know, there are the resources.